turning too quickly. Can you turn too quickly? Yes. It is possible to steer the bike so quickly that the sudden load on the tires is enough to completely lose traction. That is the real limit. How often does it happen? Well, how many times have you seen someone turn in, lose the front end, and crash? Being too heavy on the brakes and turning at the same time not included. It's very rare. On-gas crashes outnumber these 500 to 1. The obvious other exception is turning too quickly on wet or otherwise slippery surfaces. Suspension set too soft, allowing the forks to bottom out, can also promote loss of traction at turn entry. Doug, I don't think you could ever turn the bike quick enough to lose the front unless it was set up wrong or there was something on the track. Quick turn SRs. Whatever your steering skill level, pushing past it is guaranteed to fire up your SRs. In fact, the SRs make riders do it backwards. The in too fast button gets pushed, and the rider slows up his steering rate, uncertain of himself and what to do when the steering rate should be quickened. Of course, you can't quicken the steering if you're still hard on the brakes. As mentioned, most pro riders are constantly searching for a speed that pushes, slides the front end slightly at turn entry. This gives them a real limit to shoot for, but not to overstep. Track positioning. Some lean angle changes should not be made quickly. Positioning the bike for a turn entry with a lazy turn in to set up for your major steering action might be looked on as making two steering changes. This would violate the first and second rules of steering. One steering action, as quick as possible. But it really doesn't. It is track positioning, and here are some examples of when it is useful. 1. The entrance of the turn is very wide and would be a waste of time to start your turn from the far outside. 2. A quick under-acceleration steering change would shake the bike excessively. 3. A slow turn-in under braking turn entry when positioning the bike quickly for the turn point could overload the front tire and cause the front wheel to lock. 4. A bad bump at the turn entry must be hit square on with the bike nearly vertical. The bike is then quickly turned. Making a quick turn action or using a steep lean angle over the bump will bottom the suspension and cause a loss of traction. Doug said, "If you don't have to use full track, don't. You can use too much and waste time." Quick turn remedy. Stiff on the bars under braking and at turn entry makes turning the bike far more difficult. The most efficient way to steer is with your forearms as flat as possible, directing your energy into steering and not partially wasting your energy by pushing the bar downward. You instantly become stronger and able to turn it quicker with every degree of angle you drop your elbows. Power to turn. How much pressure can you actually apply to a set of handlebars? Both Eddie Lawson and Freddie Spencer bent standard mustache bars on late 1970s and early 80s 1000cc superbikes. You'd have to see it to believe it, right? Well, something you can see is modern-day frame design, which allows riders to turn quicker without hinge-in-the-middle wobbles. Modern perimeter frames basically have two advantages when compared to the frames on the wobble-prone superbikes of a decade ago. The modern frames, 1, keep the wheels in alignment when the rider applies steering input, 2, keep the wheels in alignment when the tires take the cornering load. The perimeter frame is a very high-tech solution to the SRs which used to accompany turning a bike quickly. A quick turn used to wind up the frame like a spring and pay you back in entry wobbles. Quick turning a big, overloaded touring bike can still give you this 1970s race bike thrill. Errors. Steering too slowly opens the door for lots of errors. 1. Turning too soon. 2. Going too wide. 3. Waiting too long to get back on the gas. 4. Making mid-turn steering corrections. 5. Using too much lean angle. 6. Going rigid on the bars. The limit. The major limit to your turn entry speed is how quickly you can steer. Improving this one ability will do more for your turn entry confidence than any other single thing and will help solve all 6 of the above errors and SRs. Can you practice this safely on the street? Learn to turn. Donnie Green. Confidence in the bike to steer it takes practice. You have to force yourself to get out of the brakes and turn the thing. You have to remember that the act of turning the bike scrubs off speed all on its own. I see street riders braking and turning at the same time because they don't know this, and they always wind up with a low entry speed. They get hit with the SRs of going into turns. I think finishing the braking and then relying on your steering is the right way to learn instead of dragging the brakes into turns.